Hello friends, today we will solve problem related to reflection, which is also called as mirror. The problem is an equilateral triangle ABC with length of side 10 units each is to be transformed into isosceles triangle, that is A dash, B dash, C dash. So equilateral triangle has been given, ABC is to be transformed into isosceles triangle, that is A dash, B dash, C dash, and with altitude 2.5 times of equilateral triangle, which means that altitude is 2.5 times the equilateral triangle, and the coordinate of A has been given, that is 10, 5, and we have to find the resultant transformation. So this is A, B, C, and the upper one is the equilateral triangle, and with dash, that is A dash, B dash, and this is C dash, it is isosceles triangle. So I will give rough diagram just for understanding purpose. This is a solution. So this is that equilateral triangle, that is A, B, C, okay, and the coordinate of A and is 10, 5. This is the initial figure, which is equilateral triangle. This equilateral triangle is to be transformed into isosceles triangle. So we have to convert this triangle into isosceles triangle. So I will name it as by dash, A dash, B dash, and C dash. The coordinate is 10, 5. This is the final figure, which is to be converted into isosceles triangle. So for converting this triangle, that is equilateral triangle, into isosceles triangle, we have to perform series of transformation. So from the figure it is clear that the size of isosceles triangle is greater than the size of equilateral triangle, and the C, the point C, was in first quadrant, and here the point C is in fourth quadrant. So here it is clear that we have to do scaling and mirror, that is reflection. So first transformation I will do, that is translation, because scaling is done with respect to origin, and unless and until the figure is not brought to origin, we can't perform scaling operation. So the first transformation is translation. That is, we will translate point A to origin. That is translating point A to origin. So for translation transformation, we will require the value of Tx and Ty. So for bringing this point to this point, that is origin, we are moving in this direction, that is from right to left, and we have to move 10 units. So the sign convention is negative, and we have to move 10 units. So it is minus 10. And along y direction, we are moving in downward direction by 5 units. Since we are moving in downward direction, the sign convention is minus. So I got the value of Tx as minus 10 and value of Ty as minus 5. We know the standard matrices for translation is 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, Tx, Ty, 1. So now I will replace the value of Tx and Ty, the corresponding matrix I will get as minus 10, minus 5, 1. So this is matrices for translation. So after performing this transformation, the figure will become in this way. So now we successfully brought the triangle to origin. Now this next transformation we will do, mirror, because we have to bring this point into fourth quadrant. For that I have to perform mirror transformation. So second transformation I will do is mirror transformation. As this is x-axis, we will do mirror about x-axis. So now we successfully translated this triangle to origin. So now we have to do mirror, because we have to bring the point C on fourth quadrant. Initially it is in first quadrant and we have to bring it to fourth quadrant. For that we have to perform mirror, and this is x-axis, so we have to do mirror about x-axis. So next transformation is mirror about x-axis. So the standard matrices for mirror about x-axis is mx 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1. So this is matrices for mirror about x-axis. So after performing this transformation, we successfully mirror the triangle. So now figure will become this is A dash, B dash and C dash. So we reflected about this x-axis, and we have to increase the size of this triangle, because the size of the equilateral triangle is less than the size of isosceles triangle. So now we will increase the size of this triangle, that is equilateral triangle, because we have to transform this triangle into isosceles triangle. So for that I have to do scaling transformation. So third transformation is scaling. So for scaling we will require the value of sx and sy, that is scaling along x direction, sy scaling along y direction. So now we will see the value of sx and sy. So you can see only the height, that is altitude, is changed. The side AB remains the same, that is unchanged. The height, that is altitude, has been changed. So I will write, this is ABC and this is as A dash, B dash and C dash. So this is the altitude. I will name it as altitude for equilateral triangle as x. Okay. And it has been said that isosceles triangle A dash, B dash, C dash, as shown in the figure, with altitude 2.5 times the altitude of equilateral triangle. So here the altitude of equilateral triangle is x, and it has been said the altitude of isosceles triangle is 2.5 times the equilateral triangle. So I can write as the altitude of this as 2.5x. Since the scaling is done along y direction and there is no change in the x direction, so I will write it as 1. So sy, so scaling is done along y direction, so the formula for getting sy is new figure in y direction upon original figure in y direction. So the new figure in y direction is 2.5x, and original figure in y direction is x. So it is 2.5x and original figure is x, so I will cancel x, so I will get 2.5. so the value of sy is 2.5. the now I will write now the standard matrices for scaling. It is sx 0 0 0 sy 0 0 0 1. I will replace the value of sx and sy. The corresponding matrices I will get as 1 0 0 0 2.5 0 0 0 1. So after performing this transformation, that is scaling transformation, the figure will become a dash b dash c dash. So the size has been increased, that is altitude has been increased. Since the point A was away from origin and we have brought this point to origin to perform the transformation, that is scaling transformation and mirror transformation. So now I will translate the point A to its original position. For that case I have to do translation, that is back translation. So the last transformation I will do, that is translation transformation. So for transformation is translation, I will write it as translate point A dash, or you can write it as A, back to its original position. So for that I will require the value of tx and ty. We know that the coordinate of A was 10,5. Since we are moving in this direction by 10 units, that is positive direction, and we are moving in upward direction, that is in positive direction, by 5 units, so the value of tx is positive 10, the value of ty is positive 5. This is 10 and this is 5. So I will write the matrices for translation, which is 1 0 0 0 1 0 tx ty 1. So now I will replace the value of tx and ty, so I will get as tx is 10, ty is 5 and it is 1. So now after performing the translation performation, that is back translating, the figure will become somewhat this way. This figure is just for idea, means how the transformation is going on. So now we have to calculate the resultant transformation. We know that for resultant transformation, which is also called as total transformation, for that we have to multiply all the series of transformation which I have done in this problem. So the resultant transformation, I will name it as TR. So first I have done translation transformation, then we have done mirror about x-axis, then we have done scaling, and then we have done back translation. So I will multiply all these matrices. So after multiplying all these matrices, I will get TR as one zero 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 minus 2.5 zero zero 17.5 1. So this is the resultant transformation. Thank you.